My name is Jason Pratt, and I've been playing drums since I was 2 years old. From a small community in southeastern Indiana called North Vernon, Indiana. And yeah, glad to be here. This will be awesome. My love for music really came from my family. My mom is a musician. My aunts are musicians, and so they play piano and organ. And so my love for music really started at a young age because there was always music playing in the house, you know, in the background, you know, just being in the house every day. There was always some sort of music playing, from some old Southern gospel stuff to some church choirs. So that's really when my love for music started. And my love for drums specifically started when I was 2 years old, and just the fascination with the instrument and keeping the beat and just everything that goes into playing drums was fascinating to me, and I wanted to learn. So I learned at a young age, but just music overall, my love for it really came just from family and always something being played in the background at home. Well, I would say from the spiritual side of it, God qualifies us, you know, when it comes to ministry. So also I would say just my experience from playing countless church services, camps and conferences and things, just experience will qualify you, because you'll learn what not to do and what also to do. Just that overall, you know, knowledge that you gain with years of experience, having the opportunity to play different things has helped qualify me. Honestly, you know, starting to play drums at a young age, at 2, 3, you know, years old, I didn't really know what the setbacks that I faced then, other than, you know, when I started playing, just being too short and my feet not reaching the kick pedal or hi-hat pedal. That really wasn't a setback. It was just all a matter of growing and getting tall enough. But I would say, and not even maybe a setback, but one of the things that was the biggest challenge for me was really learning how to play with like click tracks and metronomes, drum loops, whatever the case may be. You know, growing up as a kid in church and stuff, you know, we really didn't have a lot of that technology and stuff, and I didn't practice with them. But when they started being integrated into what we do, almost on a daily basis, you know, what we do on the normal in church, you know, it's abnormal not to have some sort of click track or drum loop or something nowadays. So when it became popular and it became, you know, being integrated into services, I really need to buckle down and learn and become comfortable with this. It's not that really I couldn't do it, but it was a matter of becoming comfortable with it to where, you know, you could play with it and to become second nature. So that wasn't really a setback as much as it was just an overall challenge. And so I would say that has been probably one of the biggest challenges. And then maybe really, you know, we don't do much nowadays without some sort of drum cage around the drums, and learning how to become comfortable with being a little more isolated in our services and things. Those are kind of the couple things that were a little bit of a challenge, not so much a setback, but just a challenge to learn and learn how to navigate the different things, the unknown. Really, honestly, I would say when it comes to performing, you know, if you're playing a concert or a gig, I'd say the most important thing is to be prepared. If you're not prepared and you don't know the material, you'll be like a fish out of water. Even though you may be comfortable playing drums or playing bass, keys, guitar, if you come to a gig unprepared, that is one thing that, you know, you should never be unprepared. It's unfair to your bandmates, the people you're playing with, who have put in, you know, weeks and months of practice for whatever event that you may be playing. You know, it's unfair to them to put in all the work and you not be prepared and put into work. So I would say probably most definitely being prepared. Well, how I prepare, just me personally, is just practice. And I know that's kind of the cliche answer, but play the songs, play the tracks over and over and again, you know, countless hours spent learning. And so my big thing is just repetition. practice certain parts. If you're having trouble with an intro, practice that intro over and over again until you can't get it wrong, and then just move on to the next song. So the thing that I do is just basically break the song down in sections, learn the intro, learn the verse, learn the chorus, just learn it section by section. And I have felt that that's what has helped me be prepared, is just practice, and then not learning the whole song at once, but breaking the song down by section and learning it little bit, you know, by little, and then coming back together when you feel comfortable and playing the song all the way through. And then even if you struggle at that point, just keep breaking down and working on the areas that you need to work on whatever song you may be working on. Probably the obvious answer for that is the most important thing is constantly have fresh heads. Make sure you've got good drum heads on your drum kit. After a while, what happens with the drum heads is they become dead and worn out. And not just your top head, but also your bottom head as well, your resonant head. A lot of times what happens when those become old, there's a lot of air that is trapped in between the drum from the top head to the bottom head. And so the bottom head becomes worn out from all the air that moves through the drum. And so that bottom head is what controls your tone. And so keeping good, fresh set of drum heads on not just the top, but on the bottom will ensure that you get good tone. And you know, putting good quality drum heads on your kit is very, very important. Also, when you change your drum heads, and making sure that you're cleaning your drums, make sure they're properly cleaned around the edges, make sure your drum head seats properly. And that's the most important thing, you know, when it comes to drum maintenance, just like it would be like with guitar or bass, making sure you have fresh strings and keep the neck on the guitar clean. With drums, it's very important to get that good tone. You gotta keep good heads on your drums at pretty much all times. You know, like if you're taking your kit to go play a gig, it's a good thing if you haven't replaced your heads for a while to replace your heads. That way you get peak performance, you get the most out of your drum shell that you possibly can, you get the best sound. If you got a maple drum, you want the best, you know, clear, rich tone that you can get out of a maple tone drum, and the way you're going to get that is to ensure that you have the fresh drum heads on your kit. Do as far as drumsticks go, ProMark has kind of been where I've hung out for a long time. I love the traditional Hickory 5A ProMark drumstick, and then on my drum kit, I like Evans heads on my toms and Evans EMAD on my kick drum, and then on the snare drum in particular, I kind of like more of what Remo offers in a snare drum. So drumsticks, ProMark for the toms, kick drum, Evans. I really love the Evans G2 heads. They're a clear head, great drum head. They're real lively and clear. And then the Evans EMAT on the kick drum offers nice punch, and you get a lot of good punchy low end out of your kick drum. And then as far as the snare drum, a Remo Ambassador. Evans also makes a good drum head. It's a dry drum head. It's kind of got some muffling on the inside of it. Takes out some of the overtones of your snare drum, which is a great snare drum head. But normally I like to go Remo. I like what they offer better in snare drum. But so yeah, it's ProMark, Evans, and Remo are kind of the standard for me. For both scenarios, gigging and recording, is being prepared. And I know that's kind of the generic answer, but being prepared is like, it's the most important thing you can do, and that's why it applies to most questions that you may give an answer to. So one of the biggest things for recording is learning either how to read drum music or learning what is called the Nashville number system, which doesn't apply as much to drums as it does like guitars and keys, but the Nashville number system allows you to follow along on the song, and you can kind of hear the chord progressions, and it makes it easier to follow a song, and that way you can get through a song faster. It doesn't take as many takes to get through a song when recording. One of the biggest lessons is like when you're playing a gig and you're playing live, you are going to mess up. That's just part of it. That's just part of being human. And it's being able to navigate when you do mess up and not making it sound or look so obvious. It's being able to move on from that, you know, and just put it out of your mind. That's one of the biggest challenges for me as a musician, as a drummer, is like, even playing live, you know, you're gonna mess up and it's okay. And I have to remind myself of this all the time, because sometimes I have a tendency to get down on myself. It's like, oh man, you should be better than that. That shouldn't happen, you know, but it does happen. And so being able, especially in a church service, is more important than like a gig or a concert, but being in a church service where you want to be as professional as possible, but knowing that you're not at the church service to perform. So if you do mess up, it's okay. Just move past it and just carry on with the service. Don't let that affect how you flow in the remainder of the service. So that's one of the most important lessons that I've not learned. I'm still currently learning that. But when it comes to playing live, just knowing that it's not necessarily okay to mess up, but it is okay. You know, I just expect a lot of myself. So just being able to move past that and just continue to flow in the service after mess ups happen, because they do happen. The most important thing is practice. You know, over the years, given lessons to different people, lessons do not matter if the student doesn't take the lesson and take what they've learned and apply it to their everyday practice. So taking your skill set to the next level requires countless hours of practice, and without practice, you're never going to get to where you need to be. So you've got to put in the time. If you want to be good, you've got to put in the time. You've got to put in the effort to be better. There's some people who are just a natural, but even when you're a naturally gifted musician, there still has to be a certain amount of practice that goes into it, because there's skill that has to be learned that is not necessarily just natural. So you can have all the lessons in the world you want, but if you don't take those lessons and apply them to your daily practice routine, then you're never really going to be able to take your skill set to the next level. So practice when it comes to music is probably, it's definitely one of the most important things, if not the most important, because without it, yeah, you'll never take your skill set to the next level that it needs to go, or the next level that you want to reach. You've got to be willing to put in the time and the effort and the hard work that it takes to get there.